What do I do? I what? Wait, sorry. What do I do? I thought there were gonna be questions. Oh, good. Come on, ask questions. This is so awkward.
Yeah, I'm a little sick. I'm a little drunk.
A little drunk, a little sick.
Your producer made me do a shot of two shots of tequila.
Well, we have the top people in the business here, yeah. Two shots of tequila.
Two shots of tequila and a beer, but the beer was my decision.
Okay, all right.
And now here you are. You're nominated again. I mean, you're like Mr. Big Shot.
Sorry, that was flip.
Yeah, I know.
That was so powerful.
Yeah, that was good.
I'm like a dragon. Yeah. Oh my God.
You nearly horked up something. Yeah. That would have been good.
Yeah. Yeah. But, Mr. Big Shot. Yeah. You think that's a big shot? Wait till you see this. Yeah.
I got a little something for you.
Well, I thought I figured it was the flu. Like the day of the Globes, I woke up with like 100 something degree fever and was just like,
oh my God.
And then, and then it just kind of turned into. Now I'm on an inhaler, which is actually awesome because that was my dream when I was little. I wanted to have asthma so bad. So I love this inhaler.
If you're friends with Harvey Weinstein, like you can have anything you want. Just be like, can you make a movie about this lamp? Okay.
I kicked myself in the face, only I didn't kick myself. I hit myself with an 8-pound carbon fiber bow. Yeah, my own arm betrayed me.
I love your dates, though, I gotta say. I think you have really good dates tonight.
My date?
Oh. Mom and Dad.
I thought you meant like the season. I was like, what? It's cold. Oh, yeah, I do.
They don't know that.
In the entire world.
Today I got a chest x-ray.
Okay.
Of my lungs and discovered that my breasts are uneven. That was all I saw. I
you think know my, what? My lungs same thing fine. Happened to me. It's okay.
I was like standing there with these doctors, and they're like looking at my lungs, and then I was just like, I couldn't. It felt like an elephant in the room, and I was like, are my breasts uneven? And they were just kind of like stifled and uncomfortable, obviously. And then so I kept thinking, well, I'm gonna dig myself out of this hole by bringing it up again.
Uh-huh,
so he's like, all right, well, our radiologist will get back to you about, you know, your lungs. And I was like, and my breasts. And he was just like, well, bye.
Oh, what does it say? I beat Meryl.
I just thought it was like, well, first of all, it's Meryl Streep.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can't.
It was an allusion to that
Meryl
movie.
Streep.
And Bette Midler goes into Goldie Hawn's apartment.
Yeah.
And she picks up the award and she says, look what it says.
She says, look what it says.
I beat Meryl. That's what you were saying.
And that's what I said.
And all of a sudden,
And then all of a sudden, I hate Meryl Streep.
Exactly.
It's like,
you've been gunning for her.
Yeah. I was like, is that what this turned into? I don't like Meryl Streep. If like I've had my eyes on getting that girl forever, and I was like, finally.
Yeah. Take her down a couple of notches.
I knew it would happen one day.
You mentioned in your award speech that moment, that gig that got you the SAG card way back then.
Yeah.
If you could go back to that version of yourself and give yourself a snapshot of what was going to happen in the coming years, what would you say to that version of you?
I would never tell that version of me that this was going to happen. I would become a nightmare. I'd be like, well, of course. And I was a 14-year-old idiot. It wouldn't have been a good idea. I would have probably just been like, you're going to fail. So stop being so full of yourself.
Are you going to enjoy it more this time around?
Yes.
I was really nervous the first year, but now I'm going to have fun. I'm just going to drink more this year.
Yeah.
That's what it
is. That's the message. Just drink more.
You know, before I was so focused, I was so scared. I was just a 20-year-old. I was brand new to the industry. And now I see familiar faces. And I'm older, obviously. I'm so
much older.
I wasn't even officially really offered the role yet, or maybe secretly offered the role, where it was very under wraps, and don't bring it up, don't do anything. And I see my mother, surrounded by reporters. Well, my favorite book is The Hunger Games. Wink.
Oh, my brother made so, I was back in Kentucky and I said that. And I was like, well, I had a midnight call time one time for Mystique. And he goes, oh, I'm sorry. It's really hard what you do. I bet they can find somebody else to do it. And I was like, now I can't brag about call times.
Have you gotten a chance to see the script for Days of Future Past? Do you know what the next...
Days of Future what?
You're in an X-Men movie called Days of Future Past.
Is that what they're calling it? I didn't know. What?
Dude,
they don't
really?
Tell me anything.
I love that you have a microphone. Mom is the statue. You've got your champagne.
I've got my champagne.
He still hasn't put it down. There are so many tables everywhere.
You should be celebrating.
Have you heard from Ms. Streep?
No, I don't know if I want to. I don't know what.
Well, of course, she can take
nervous.
A joke for God's sake.
I'm sure she hasn't heard.
What about
heard?
These
she
dopes
care?
That don't get the joke? What about those dopes?
I know. I wanted to make a public statement, like, "Hey, idiots!" It's a quote from a movie, and it's Meryl Streep.
Sure.
Brett, I just found out the other night at a Q&A, it was the first take, because I remembered the first time that I went in, I did all of the lines right, and then for the rest of the day, I was like, I'm like, couldn't get all of the sports teams right.
But David's thing was he would always be really close. Like, we were doing a diner scene where he was laying down in the booth right next to me, like 3 inches away, and I'm talking and doing the scene, and I just hear him start to go, oh, God. Oh, I hate it. Oh, it's so bad. And I finally just like, do you want me to do something else? And he's like, yes, anything.
Oh, really?
I'm always like, yeah, I'm going to party. And I'm like texting people. I'm like, come out. And then I'm like, never mind. I'm in bed by 7:30. So
yeah, I read you like to kick it and be more of a homebody,
I do,
right?
Well, and I'm very flaky. I'm a very, very flaky.
Oh, you're
person.
A flake?
Yes,
I didn't figure you for a flake.
Life is too short to not be flaky. I'm just like, I want to do whatever I want to do.
I like that motto.
But I warn people that I'm flaky. So I'm like, yes, I'm going to the after party, but I might cancel.
You give them a heads up.
Yeah.
All good then.
Yeah.
You plead guilty to all those descriptions?
I'm going to have to read over
well,
them.
Let's go
again.
Through them. Are you rude?
Well, unintentionally, yes, unfortunately.
Are you dirty?
Well, I mean, I'm not dirty. What does that mean? No, I'm not dirty.
In the best way.
I'm not afraid of dirt.
Okay, that's a good compromise.
There we go.
Not afraid of dirt. Are you funny? We know you're funny.
I'm hilarious.
Are you foul-mouthed?
Yes.
Are you going to try and change that?
Yeah, I am. I'm working on it.
Going to try and be better?
Yeah.
Are you sloppy?
Yeah.
Are you sexy?
This is horrible. Why did I even rush here?
I was laughing last night because my friend, when I first started getting recognized, we were like at a bar, and anytime anybody came up, I was like, are you Jennifer Lawrence? She just would start snapping. She's like, no! And like started like ripping me away. And then one of my friends, we were driving to breakfast and we were being followed by a paparazzi, and she got so overwhelmed that she had to pull the car over and was crying. And she was like, I just know, how is this legal? We can't live like this. This is horrible. And I'm like, it's okay.
You'll be
it's been
okay.
Really hard on my friends.
And now I have this naked statue that means that some of you even voted for me.
What do you think about her winning all these awards, Mom?
If you stick that in her mouth, I mean, I'm going to start crying.
That's not how microphones work. She will not put it in your mouth.
I promise you I won't.
That's a big fear.
I just can't stop crying.
Oh, look at her. You are going to cry.
Stop crying.
Stop it.
And does that make you start getting teared up when your parents
do? No, never.
Just
like, stop crying, woman.
Well, there's going to be
my
very
dad
well.
And I both like react differently on camera. My dad and I turn into compulsive rednecks, and my mother just turns into like weeping willow. Just can't get it together.
It's a nice combination. Dad's not here tonight.
Great. We're a totally normal family.
Yeah.
I'm drunk. She's crying.
You're as American as anybody else. Yeah. I'll say that.
I tried to Twitter, and I have nothing to say. I don't get it.
I feel that would be like a punishment for me. Like a judge would have to be like 6 months of, you know, probation, and you have to write down what you think about random things that nobody cares about.
It's me, Dave. I think I have searing abdominal cramps.
Yeah.
Great.
What's anal leakage? Dash, Jen Lawrence.
Well, now, wait a minute. I never thought about it in those terms.
Sorry, you said abdominal cramps. That's not the next thing. Anal leakage.
No, well, I mean...
Would you come here tonight with?
With my parents.
Oh, where are your parents?
I don't know. I'm embarrassed.
Are you embarrassed?
Yeah.
Everybody's been bringing
their... I feel like I'm bringing my parents to too many things. I'm like starting to get... I'm like, yeah, I've got... Starting to do that like 5-year-old thing where I'm like, I don't have parents.
My friend who was looking at paparazzi pictures of herself, she was feeling guilty, so I Googled Jennifer Lawrence ugly to like make her feel better. And my mother saw it on my internet history and she was like,
and the pictures came up.
What are you doing? Well, yeah, of course they came up. You should type, that's like a fun thing to do, actually. Jennifer Lawrence ugly is like.
Jennifer, I Googled your name, and I don't know if you know this, but when you type in Jennifer, not even your surname, the first person pop up is you, above Jennifer Aniston, Jennifer Lopez.
Really?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
If you type in G-E, does Jesus come up or me?
I mean, that's an example.
G-E? Did I say G-E?
G-E. Yeah, Jesus and not spelled with G-E.
Wow. Neither is Jennifer, which is funny.
That they know who I am and that they voted for me is just, it's incredible. That is a really unbelievable feeling. I can hear her whimpering behind me, so. I just heard a slight...
Okay, and now, are you prepared for the Oscars? Will you write a speech?
No.
You will not?
I haven't, no, I've started this new, it's like my only superstition of not preparing anything to say, because when I start, when I, the first, it feels cocky to just like...
I agree with you.
Yeah, it's just like, oh, that seems presumptuous. I'm not going to do it. And then we start like get in the car and I'm like, everyone's asking me like, do you have anything prepared? I'm like, stop! Like, because it just stresses me out.
Yeah.
I don't react that way because I'm not normally on two shots of tequila. God.
Okay, well, there's Jessica Chastain.
She was great, by the way, in Zero Dark Thirty.
Yes, yeah. She was incredible.
You should have been in that movie. did they ask you to be in that movie?
No.
I bet they did.
They didn't, actually.
I bet they did.
Yeah, I should have been in the background like, yeah, catch him. Yeah. Obama.
All right.
Obama. I mean, Osama.
Yeah, I know.
Bin Laden. Don't catch Obama.
No.
Sorry.
This is one of our best rehearsals ever.
I just had to give my mom a talk about coming over, waiting to be invited before she comes over into my house. I woke up this morning and I was like, hello? Hello? And she was just like, hi. And I was like, I didn't give you a key. And she was like, your door was open. You're like, you broke into my house. But
what do you think when you look in the mirror?
I'm just trying to figure out what to do with what I got.
Usually the people who win the SAG Award go on to win the Oscars.
That's very sweet. That's really nice. Thank you so much. Dad, can I have some champagne?
You said it was so hard.
Yeah.
Can we see it in our little Manny cam, Jennifer? You can put it. Walk the carpet.
Chubby fingers, though.
You do not have chubby
fingers.
You do.
Look.
Da da da. Da 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 da. You are having way too much fun with the Manny cam. We'll send one home to you.
Well, I was sitting with my family and Bradley and David, everybody, but Adele was in the table that was right. It was the next table over, and I had such a high fever, and I felt like I couldn't move. And I saw Adele, and there was nobody in the way, and she was sitting in the table by herself. And I was sitting. My dad was sitting next to me here, and I just reached my arm out, and went. And my dad goes like, "What, Jen? What's the matter?" And I was like, "It's Adele." Adele right there.
You got no quality time with Adele at all.
I couldn't say anything.
Adele was probably happy at that point that you weren't touching her with your.
Yeah, come over with 103. I'm sorry.
Your fever hands.
Yeah. Well, the tiny little girl.
Yes, Cuvangene.
Yes, she's like 9 years old.
Yes, and
now,
she's incredibly talented.
Now,
I
don't want you.
Too.
You understand that they've pulled this in the past where they sneak around and give it to a kid.
Oh, God. Well,
so I'm just
then
telling
I'll pull
you now.
Another, then I'll pull another Meryl.
Yeah. Go
set the
right.
world.
Go after the kid.
Yeah, I'll go after the child
Smart.
Next.
Yeah, that's right.
First a legend, then a child.
Exactly.
I'll be set.
Are you going to remain the same as your mom said, like with all these accolades
Absolutely
and stuff?
Absolutely not. I won.